Up next, our first feature report as we head to Russia for the Skydiving World Cup. Welcome to the Drop Zone in Stupino, Russia. Located around 100 kilometers south of Moscow, this former military airbase is host to this year's FAI Skydiving World Cup, and it's an event which has attracted over 70 teams from four different continents. It's a multi-class championship showcasing the most talented jumpers in the world, and in this report we'll concentrate on two of the artistic categories, starting with free fly.
A team of three people. You have two performers and one camera flyer. There's seven jumps. Five of them, you perform a routine where you can create your own routine, but it's marked in terms of artistic merit, difficulty, camera integration, things like that. So you have to come up with something that you can do, but is also difficult, but looks nice. And then the other two rounds are compulsories. So they draw out of a hat, five compulsories for each round, and you have to do those in order as fast as you can in 35 seconds. It's been really nice to see the other team stuff as well. There's some really good flyers here today, so hopefully we'll do some fun jumps after the competition and do some cool stuff.
After three of the seven rounds, France Amnesia held a slender lead over British team Outbreak. Tora Tora from Holland were also in contention, and a point clear of Norwegian Skywalkers, one of the teams that had travelled the furthest to be here, with the Venezuelans, and their efforts were rewarded with a place in the top six. And as the teams prepared for the next round of jumps, we caught up with them to delve a little deeper into the attraction of the sport.
It's all about flying. Flying with your body, you can do many things in the air. There's nothing like this, not even with a plane. I fly planes too, and with the body is something special.
A sensational feeling it must be, but obviously this isn't exactly the safest of sports. But in the midst of a World Cup, can the competitors afford to think about the hazards?
Of course, you have to worry all the time about the danger, because it's not only you in the air, there is also new people in the air, people with no experience, crazy people. So you have to be all the time super aware of everybody, about you, about your system, about everything, yes.
Time to see these daredevils in action then, as the teams headed up for the next round of jumps. Having been fourth all the way through the competition, Dutch team Tora Tora ended the week in confident fashion. They took good scores from the judges in round 6 and 7 to give themselves a very real chance of taking the bronze medal. A final round score of 7.7 gave the Dutch a final total of 51.8, and the Norwegians needed a seriously good jump to take the bronze now. With their advantage diminishing, they needed to score at least 7.6 to grab the bronze. 45 seconds of artistic free fly to go, and no room for error. In the end, Skywalkers did just enough, taking the exact score, 7.6, that they needed to hold on to bronze. It finished with the Dutch team on 51.8 and the Norwegians on 51.9, and clearly delighted with the bronze. That left just two teams in contention for the World Cup title, and going into the closing stages, we caught up with the leaders.
Well, so far so good. We're ranking first with UK team just behind, so it's very tight until the end, so makes it more interesting for everybody. Could be better if we were more safe, but yeah, it's good to have a nice competition, so it makes the sport more interesting.
So the last round of jumps coming up, and the French team may have been all smiles, but with a fairly slender lead over the British team at break, they would have felt some pressure as they launched themselves out of the plane at 13,000 feet for the final time. Round score of 7.7 left France Amnesia on a knife edge because it was their worst score of the week. It gave them a final total of 56.2 and meant that Outbreak could steal the gold if they scored 8.7 in their final jump. A valiant effort from Outbreak, 8.3, their equal best score of the week, just 0.3 short of what was required for gold. This silver, however, was the first ever British medal at the Skydiving World Cup. Congratulations then to our top three teams in the free fly here at the Skydiving World Cup, with France Amnesia standing proudly on the top step of the podium. Welcome back to Breitling Air Sports World as we continue our look at the Skydiving World Cup from Russia. Up next, the freestyle category, and we talk with some competitors to learn more.
It's kind of like you can think of gymnastics in the air, kind of very three-dimensional flying around each other. It takes a lot of practice, a lot of discipline, good camera guy. You know, everything fits together to create a really good routine.
Our working time that gets judged is 45 seconds. We have a little bit more free fall after that, so it just keeps us safe having a time limit on our performance up there.
And although we never see them in front of the camera flyers in each team play just as crucial a role as the performers.
We're really working together to be pretty creative and really interactive. You know, I'm a pretty key element on the team. You know, basically, judges can't judge something they can't see. And, you know, the more interaction I give with him, the more creative and artistic it is for the judges to view.
The more experienced the performer is, the easier it is to film. But then again, once you get experience, you make the difficulty more difficult so that you get higher points. So it does get quite difficult to do.
Europeans took 9 of the top 10 places in the women's freestyle, and the battle for silver was one of the closest fought of the entire championship. In the end, Italy's Maria Cotterin and camera flyer Alessandro Muni took the runner-up spot, but they ended the week on exactly the same points as the Swiss team and only got the verdict based on countback of rounds won. There was, however, a clear winner as Finland's Eilo Heini and Ramsey Klass won 6 of the 7 rounds to finish over 7 points clear of their nearest rivals and take the gold. In the men's freestyle, Bryce Witcher and camera flyer Jason Peters took the World Cup silver medal. The American pairing won 2 of the 7 rounds and finished the week with a total of 57.9. Along with Britain and Russia, France was one of the best represented nations at the World Cup, and it was Frédéric Nenné and camera flyer Cyril Collin who took gold in the freestyle. With victory in 4 of the 7 rounds and the highest scoring jump of the competition, they ended the week on 60 points, 2 clear of the Americans. Well, that's all from Russia this week, but later in the series, we'll be back with a report on the four and eight-way formation Skydiving World Cup from Stupino.